गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन मैथ्स क्लास। सो लेसन नंबर 3, एचसीएफ एंड एलसीएम इज गोइंग ऑन। द इन दिस लेसन वी हैव सीन हियर को प्राइम नंबर्स, ट्विन प्राइम नंबर्स, देन आफ्टर दैट एचसीएफ, फैक्टर्स, फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड्स, देन इन लास्ट पीरियड वी हैव सीन द एलसीएम। LCM means least common multiple. Then we saw the vertical arrangement, by using vertical arrangement how to solve the LCM. Now today we are going to see the use of LCM and HCM in our daily life. See the first example. A shop sell a 450 gram bottle of jam for 96 rupees and bigger bottle of that is 600 gram for 124 rupees. Which bottle is it more profitable to buy? See, there are the two bottles, one of 450 grams and another of 600 gram. Now we have learned the unitary method. Using that we can find the cost of 1 gram jam in each bottle and compare. However, means first we will find out the 1 gram of jam of 450 gram bottles, then one cost of 1 gram jar from the 600 gram bottle, then we will compare. Instead of this, however, the calculation is easier if we use a bigger common factor rather than the smaller one. So let's use a 150, the HCF of 450 and 600 to the compare. Let's see this. The HCF of 450 and 600. The HCF of 450 and 600 is 150. Okay, you know how to solve the HCF by factorization method. Okay. So by using this method, first find out the HCF of 450 and 600. Then if you compare the 150 to the 450, so 450 means 150 multiply by 3 and 600 means 150 multiply by 4. So therefore, in small bottle, 150 gram of jam cost is equal to 96 upon 3, that is 32 rupees, and in big bottle 150 gram of jam cost is equal to how much cost of 600 gram bottle? 125 rupees. Okay, so 125 divided by what is the comparison of 600 to the 150? Sorry, it's a 154 rupees. Sorry, by mistake I told this. This is a 124 rupees. So here 124 divided by 4. That is 4 threes are 12 and 4 on the 4, 31 rupees. Thus it is more profitable to buy a 600 gram or bottle of jam. Okay, because their cost is low, so therefore it is more profitable to buy 600 gram bottle of jam. Okay. Okay, understand? First find out the HCF. Then after that compare this. Instead of unitary method, compare the one with 150 gram. Then find out their cost of 150 gram jar. And after that you will decide which one is profitable. Let's see the question number 2. If you want to find out the fraction of 17 upon 28 plus 11 upon 35. Okay. You know the addition of fraction. You already learned in the 6th standard. The addition of fraction. Here you use the cross multiplication. Means 17 multiplied by 35 plus 11 multiplied by 28 divided by 28 multiplied by 35. You use the method, see like this, 17 multiplied by 35 plus 11 multiplied by 28 upon 28 multiplied by 35. Okay, this is a too big method. See this. So instead of this, we use the LCM here. First find out the LCM of 28 and 35. Here roughly find out LCM of 28 and 35. It's a rough work. Okay. 28 is equal to 7 into 4. And the 35 is equal to 7 into 5. Let's compare with 7. 7 is a 7 into 5 into 4. It's a 140. 140 is LCM of the 28 and 35. So here first we convert this denominator into 140 and then we'll compare, then we'll add the numerators. Okay. See here to making a 140 of denominator, 28 multiply by 5, and to making a denominator 140 here, multiply 35 with 4. If you multiply 5 with denominator, then multiply with numerator also to the same number. See here, multiply by 5 to numerator and denominator, multiply by 4 to numerator and denominator. Now multiplication, 17 5 are 85 plus 140 plus 44 upon 140. See here, the denominators are same. Say write this denominator only one time. Okay, and add the denominator, that is 85 plus 44. The answer is 129 upon 140. This is the answer of this fraction. Instead of the cross multiplication, this is a very easy method. Let's see the next question. On dividing the certain number by 8, 10, 12 and 14, the remainder is always 3, which is the smallest number. See here, there are so many solutions for this example, but see this condition is smallest number. Okay, if there is no condition, then there are the many solutions. So first here, find out the LCM of 8, 10, 12 and 14. 8, 10, 12 and 14. First divide by 2. 4, 5, 6, 7. After that again divided by 2. 2 to the 4, 5 as it is. 2, 3 to the 6, 7 as it is. So here LCM is equal to LCM of 8, 10, 12 and 14 is equal to 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 5 multiply by 3 multiply by 7. The LCM of this is 814. To the LCM, we add the remainder obtained every time, so that number is equal to LCM plus remainder. So 840 plus 3, that number is 843. If the great one, remember here, if the greatest of given number is divisible by other number, then that greatest number is the LCM of given number. Let's see the more examples in next video.